In this class, we are going to talk about page factory model. In the page factory model, we separate web elements from the action methods, are also called as page methods. And these web elements we defined at the top of the class. The created web elements can be made use by any page method or action method in the page class. Let's see how we are going to deal this with a practical example. The class that you are seeing right now is a login page. In the login page, we have a lot of action methods, are also called as page methods, such as set username, is username exist, set password, click on continue button, click on login button, get error message. And all these methods are getting the web element or finding the web element, right? So once the element is found, you are performing the action. That could be sending the keys, or that could be clicking on the button, or that could be, you know, checking whether the element is exist or not. Okay. Now in the page factory model, what we do is we separate the element, finding the elements from the action method. I'm repeating once again, in the page factory model, we separate the web elements from the action methods. How do we do that? Let's see. So first of all, username web element. Okay, so let's define a web element. Username element. Okay. And how do we find the username element? By using a locator. So that is ID and whose value, username or email. Okay. Now you need to make an annotation at find by. How equal to how dot ID comma using the value of the ID, in our case username or email. Okay, and this web element, username element, you are finding it by using ID whose value username or email. And this particular web element you can make use in your action method, username element dot clear username element dot send keys and the username. Okay, so that is how we do it. So first of all, declare all the web elements that you needed to perform the actions. Then make use of these web elements in the required page classes. Okay, and we don't need these 3 lines of code anymore. So similarly, create all the web elements that are needed for this login page to perform the corresponding actions. So let's take the set password. It is password element, and you are finding the password by using ID and whose value is password. Okay, so let's define all the web elements first of all. The next one is button, continue button. Element. We're using XPath. The next one is login button. So first of all, define all the web elements that are needed to perform the actions. An error message web element error message element at find by how equal to how dot xpath using the value of the xpath. Okay, so similarly there are different other find by. Okay, so if you want to find out one single element, you can use find by. If you want to find out list of web elements, then you can use find all. Okay, so these two are the things which we'll be mostly using. So rest of the things, find by is not required. Only when in the case of you want to find an element by using multiple locators, that is something is newly introduced. If at all you want to find an element by using multiple locators, then you can use find by. That is generally we don't use it. Now we defined all the web elements that are needed. Okay, let's make use of these web elements in the page methods. Password element. Okay, so this is the password. Password. This is a web element. Password element is a web element. You can see that password element is a web element. On the web element, what we can do? We can perform the actions. As password element is a, you know, it represents a text field. You generally clear it and then send keys. Okay, so in simple, you need to understand that instead of writing this statement, line number 55, instead of writing this particular statement, now what we are doing, we are using this statement. Representing line number 55, okay, instead of doing that way, now we are using at find by annotation. So in the page factory model, we define the web elements and we make use of the web elements like this. And coming to the continue button, so continue button element, it's a click. And coming to login button element dot click. Okay, so login button is already defined in the top here. It is already defined. Okay, the web element is already available now. We just have to make use of it. And these two lines of statements are not required. And error message. Yeah, so this alone is not required. The error message element is already defined here. Okay. And let's look at this one. Is username exist? Okay. So here we don't need to define driver.find element by ID. We don't need to write the statement. Okay. We just have to make use of it. That's all. If you remember earlier, whenever we need a username element, whenever we need a username web element, so every time we do driver.find element by ID, username or email, whenever you need a username web element, every time you do driver.find element and by.id and its value, that is not required. That is not required. Okay, so you define the web elements in the very beginning once, that is enough, and make use of them n number of times anywhere in the page class. Okay, I define the username element once, define the username element only once, and I make use of the username element multiple times. So in the set username, I make use of it, and in the use is username exist method also, I make use of it. Earlier, what we were doing, so we were doing driver dot find element by dot id, and previously, this is what we are doing. Okay, this is what we are doing. If you remember, previously we are doing this. This is how we were doing in the previously. So if you see that, the same statement, line number 40 and line number 47. So these two are absolutely same. And we absolutely duplicated them. Right? And the other problem is, let's say if the ID is changed, you need to change it here. And you also need to change it in the line number 47 also. How many places you used it, those many places you have to change it. So with the help of page factory model, that is no more required. Okay, because you define the elements only once and you make use of them n number of times anywhere in the page class. That is another advantage of page factory model. So it is very much clear. If you see the login page, these are the web elements we are working on it. And these are the methods which will be working with the web elements that are defined here. The elements are separated and the page methods are separated. Very much, I know, optimization and very much separation here. Okay, and other thing is, most of the people, they forget to do this one, but you don't do that. Okay, so one more thing what you need to do is page factory dot init elements driver login page, the page name dot class. Okay, so this is one thing is required. So make sure whatever the page that you are using, if you are using the page factory model, then make sure page factory dot init elements and the driver you need to pass and login page dot class. This statement you must need to include, otherwise it will not work. So that's all about page factory model.